Welcome to Launching the Pilot with your hosts, Brian and Paul.
What if you knew, beyond a doubt, what was going to happen tomorrow? Sure, I know it's crazy, but what if you did? Whether you'd be rich or poor, a hero or a loser, lucky in love, unlucky in life. What would you do? What if, by some magic, you found the power to really change things? People, events, maybe even your life. Would you even know where to start? Maybe you can't know until it happens.
Hello, and welcome to Launching the Pilot, episode 126.
Season.
I was just looking at the board there.
Is it really? 126.
And this time we're doing early edition.
Yes.
Which is, it fits really, because we're doing this early.
We are doing this early.
Because the football was going to be on. We're trying to fit this in.
For all you non-football people out there.
Well, it'll be finished by the time this goes out.
Right, yeah.
England being lost. Yeah. Well, we've won.
Oh, we have. We're ever pessimistic.
Yeah.
We will have lost.
So this is early edition, and the first episode is called The Pilot, so that's handy.
Always handy for us.
Four seasons.
Did they? I thought it was Frankie Valli.
Yeah.
90 episodes.
90 episodes.
Yeah. 96 to the year 2000.
00.
Millennium. It's all going to go wrong.
Yeah, she was parted like it was 1999.
Well, we should have.
But we didn't. This stars Kyle Chandler as Gary Hobson.
Yeah, well, if you say so. You always look those bits up.
Yeah.
I never worry.
Fisher Stevens played Chuck Fisherman. I've seen him in a few things.
Yeah.
He's been around, isn't he?
Yeah, he's been around.
But he was usually a lot more scruffy looking.
Yes.
He was quite nicely turned out for this one. 80s stock market guy that he
well,
was.
Yeah, well, in a way of... quite turned out.
Yes,
yeah, I know what you mean.
For the stock market. Well, usually he looks like hobo.
Yeah.
I've seen him in hobo. And so Shanice, would you say Davis, as Marcy Clark.
She was
a blind receptionist.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, I was going to say. And the other one was the copper.
Oh, right.
And I recognised her, and she's from Desperate Housewives.
Oh, was that what it was? Yes. Now you said it.
Oh, no. And I was, I think, I know, I do know that person.
Yeah, hey, watch something, you're thinking, yeah, I know.
So that was the only thing I looked up. Who was she? Oh, Desperate Housewife. Oh, okay. And that was that.
Like, I was watching this program, I was watching the first season of Atlanta. Don't know if you know that one.
No.
Anyway, but then this woman, like old age.
A woman?
A woman, so, yeah.
A woman?
Yeah.
You said it, sir!
She turns it up in one episode. She's like an agent, and she's a bit bitter, but she thinks she recognises...
A bitter woman?
She thinks she recognises the main character. She calls him Alonzo. I thought, I know her. I know her from somewhere.
Yeah.
And I just wouldn't come to me. I thought, I'm going to have to look it up in the end. And she was in the Frasier. She was Niles' wife.
Oh, what, Meris?
Not Meris, because you never saw Meris.
I was going to say, you never saw Meris.
The other one. The one who was the plastic surgeon.
Oh, yes. Yeah, that he sort of did on the bounce and then...
Then realised Daphne loved him.
And don't give this plot away.
How many years ago since he finished?
It's never finished.
Well, so you want to do a podcast, Frasier, episode by episode?
Oh,
so that would take us the rest of our lives, wouldn't it?
Yeah, probably.
Was it 27 seasons?
Someone's probably already done it.
Oh, God, everyone. There's a podcast about everything somewhere.
There's probably a podcast about this podcast.
Podcasts about podcasts. I'm sure there is.
Fools.
Anyway.
Mad fools.
Back to the programme.
Oh, yes. What was we doing?
We're going to race through it. So there's a talky intro.
Yes, I've got here. What if you know what's going to happen tomorrow,
what if you
tomorrow,
know what you know
today?
That you know is going to know happens, yeah.
You knows.
Yeah, and then we get Gary's, I guess, is his wife.
Yeah,
throwing his stuff.
He comes home, he's got a bunch of flowers and chocolates, I presume, yeah, and he's happy anniversary. And he goes to get, and he can't get in the house, can he?
No.
And he calls out, I can't remember her name.
No, I don't even.
You know, Maris, that'll do. Maris, you know, and she just throws out all his clothes.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh.
Yeah. And then we get the intro.
Then we get the titles, yeah.
And that's that.
Yeah. He wakes up, it's Monday morning, 6:30.
Yeah.
11th of November, I noted, because it's actually my sister's birthday there.
Yeah, and it's also, is it Remembrance Day?
It is UK? Remembrance
it's
Day,
it's also
yes.
Armed Forces Day in America.
Wow.
And the stock exchange wouldn't be open.
Possibly not.
No.
Possibly not.
They've got a really tight boss there, haven't they? Yeah. They can work on...
Yeah. And, yeah, he's woken up, hasn't he?
There's news going on the radio.
Yeah.
And I wonder if this will come back to
his mate turns up, doesn't he?
Not right away.
I thought Chuck knocks on the door, doesn't he? Yeah. Says, oh, come on, you're late, aren't you? Yeah. Come on, what time do you call this? We've got to be in the office, blah, 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 blah.
Oh, yeah, it's been a week or so since she kicked you out. You've got to get back out.
Get over it.
It's over. Accept it.
I'm leaving now. I'll see you about 10-ish.
Yeah.
And that's it. He goes, doesn't he?
That's it, yeah.
And... he hears something. He hears a knock. Is it a knock on the door? He hears the cat.
I think it's like a thump on the door.
Yeah, he hears like a thump on the door and a cat.
He hears meowing.
Yeah. And he goes to open the door and there's a cat there sat on a newspaper.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
He didn't ask for a newspaper, but there's one there.
So he brings it in and he's reading it, isn't he?
He's just flipping through the sports and some of the stock things and...
But
not really paying that much attention to it.
But he has heard the stuff on the radio, hasn't he?
Yes.
And that's where he realises that some of the headlines are wrong.
It's about the president meeting with someone to discuss some sort of trade deal. I think it's a trade deal.
Yeah.
But that hasn't been accepted yet.
But the headline says that it has.
Trade deal,
goes through, blah, blah, blah. But he doesn't really pay much attention to it, does he?
No. You notice the headline, and there's about homeless men winning the lottery.
Yeah.
And you notice the date on the paper is the 12th of November.
Yeah.
But he doesn't know much more of that, does he?
No. Is that when he then goes off to buy... He goes to his old newsstand, doesn't he?
Newsstand, yeah, with the old
there's
guy.
There's a guy there.
I recognise that guy as well.
Yeah. Takes a stick of bubble gum or something. And he goes, oh, do you want the paper? He goes, no, I've already got it.
Yeah.
He goes, oh, you're getting it from rivals. Are you going to put me out of business?
Yeah.
And he just goes off to work, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Meets the...
receptionist, Melissa.
Oh, sorry, before that, he talks about the game. The guy says, who do you think's going to win tonight? Is it the Knicks or whatever?
It's the Bulls and the over Magic.
Yeah, and he goes, oh, the
Bulls by 10.
Bulls by 10. He goes, well, what are you talking about? They don't win anything. Yeah. He goes, oh, no. He says in the newspaper. And he's like, hey, lunatic.
Hey, kid. Who do you like? Bulls of the Magic.
The Bulls took it by 10 last night.
When did you hear that?
Read in the paper.
Go off, don't you? So yeah, he turns up at work, the blind receptionist.
She needs a dog. apparently.
Well, apparently so, yeah.
I've got arse hat as a boss. Typical boss.
Yeah.
And it's the stock trade, isn't it? And Chuck's on a losing his shirt.
Yes, and
he says, "Oh, don't put your money in that. It's we already know it's going to jump 30." He goes, "What? It's not going to jump 30." He goes, "Yeah, it's jump 30. I read it in the paper."
Yeah. He goes, "What are you on about?" Anyway, it goes.
Suddenly,
it does. It jumps 30.
Yeah.
Look at winter wheat. It's really moving. Don't touch it. It went up 30 yesterday. It's going to drop.
Garrett, wake up. Yesterday was Sunday. Market was closed.
I read the paper.
What paper?
This morning, the headline, it said winter wheat jumps 30.
And he goes, what? He says something else, does he, about the newspaper? He goes, what newspaper? He goes, oh, the one that was delivered this morning. He goes, let's have a look at it.
It's back at his hotel room.
Yeah, so they go back to the hotel room, but the garbage truck...
It's been cleaned.
Yeah, it's going down the road. So they're chasing the garbage truck, aren't they, to try and recover this paper.
Yeah, Chuck believes it straight away.
Yeah.
That he's got a paper from the future, and Gary's saying, oh, I don't think so.
Yeah,
no.
But it's gone, so they can't get it. He's having a drink in a bar, isn't he, or something?
Yeah.
The guy just turns up. Says happy anniversary or something. Oh, it's 6-day anniversary. And gives him his divorce papers, doesn't
he? That's right, yes.
I don't believe this.
Neither do I.
Something like this comes along once in a lifetime and you lose it.
What?
I'm gonna kill myself.
What are you, what are you talking about here? A newspaper that tells the future?
Shh. Look, you saw the numbers, right? We rallied at 30. Not 29, not 31, but 30. Just like you read. Now, how do you explain that?
Coincidence.
Coincidence? Did you read the sports pages?
Yeah, kinda.
UCLA versus Kentucky.
UCLA 95-85.
World Cup soccer, Brazil and Italy.
Brazil 3-2.
Yes, you've been reading the soccer scores.
All right, well, tell me this. Where does it come from?
The newspaper fairy. Who knows? The point is, it's gone. Unless it comes back again.
You know, this is crazy. I'm gonna go call Marcia.
You know, that's just like you. Heaven passes right under your nose and you don't even blink.
You know, maybe she'll talk to me.
Gary Hobson?
Yeah.
Process server. Huh? Have a nice divorce.
And he's walking home.
Yeah.
And he passes a TV shop.
Yeah.
Did he still have them?
Yeah. And he sees the homeless guy getting his check.
Yes. And he talks to a street
Another guy, yeah, he asks him for any change.
And he gives him some money. He goes, oh, thanks, mister. Anything can happen or something. Yeah.
Because he's watching the TV with him. He says, yeah, anything can happen.
And that's when, as that bum walks away, he sees the one on the telly. He's now just won the millions.
Because at first I thought, oh, is that the one who's going to win?
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Just a different one.
And then it's the next day.
Yeah, it's Wednesday the 13th for paper now. It's Tuesday, but it's Wednesday's paper.
Yeah, he wakes up. There's no paper at first.
No, he looks, but there's nothing.
Yeah, there's nothing there.
Suddenly he hears the meow.
Yeah.
And the thud.
Yeah.
And there's the paper.
There it is, yeah. And he's at work, isn't he? He's watching the stock exchange.
Chuck sees the paper.
He's giving all the boss is giving him...
Yeah, oh, hard time.
Yeah.
And he's made some stock... the boss is going, why are you investing in that? I want you to cancel all that.
Yeah.
And then Chuck goes, oh, we can't, it's too late, it's on the system.
Yeah.
He goes, but we've just won. It's just, well, not won.
Yeah.
They don't quit winning.
No, it's gone up.
Every one of the shares has gone up.
Like, brilliant. How much did you put on? He goes, $1.
Yeah, a share each.
Yeah, one share each. He goes, that's it, I'm out of here, I'll quit this.
Yeah. He goes, I'm not a tie guy, I'm done.
And he talks to the receptionist. He says he'll take her out
to lunch.
For lunch, yeah.
Actually, anywhere you want to go, he says to her.
Yeah.
So they're at the betting office.
Well, yeah, I thought it was a bet. Yeah, I wasn't quite sure what it was supposed to be at first.
It's not quite a betting office, because there is a canteen and stuff there as well.
And she always puts...
$2.
$2 on number 7 or something every time, doesn't she?
Yes.
Regardless.
Yeah.
And it never wins.
No.
But there's only 6 horses, because she's blind, she doesn't know.
It's something you realise, he's got all the winners in the paper.
Yes.
So he bets, then he keeps betting, doesn't he, in another bet. This time he's left her out there.
Yeah.
Lunch table. He says, I won't be a minute.
And all the guys have realised what he's doing.
Start listening in on
so it's on the last right, he says, like, let it all go, doesn't he? Let it all go.
He tries to whisper it, doesn't he?
Yeah. And they're all like, yeah, we're all going that. And it loses.
Yeah, I guess it can't be. It's impossible.
And then the announcer comes over. No, the winner has been disqualified. The winner is number 2, which one that he won. Yeah. And everyone's,
There you go. A lot of George Washingtons in there.
Let it ride.
Are you nuts? On who?
Sikorsky to win.
Now Sikorsky's making a move. At the turn, it's Zucker's Notion and Sikorsky neck and neck. Zucker's Notion and Sikorsky down the stretch. It's a two-horse race. Sikorsky and Zucker's Notion nose to nose. And at the wire, it's Zucker's Notion. Zucker's Notion by a nose, Sikorsky and Siamese Dream.
No, that's impossible. No. No, that's impossible.
Your attention, please. Ladies and gentlemen, hold your tickets. Zucker's notion has been disqualified. The winner is Sikorsky.
He finally gets back to the table to her.
She says, I hope you like your lunch cold.
Yeah, but he gives her all the winnings.
Yeah.
They're on the tube train home, aren't they?
Yeah.
And just as she gets off, or he gets off, well, I can't remember
which. He just hands it to her.
He hands her all the money, doesn't
he? Go get your dog.
Yeah. And now Chuck, you know, obviously he wants to have a go at this, doesn't he?
Yeah.
He wants
you. Yeah, at the bar, Chuck, yeah, you can get rich, you can get rich. Easily and quickly with this, yeah.
He's like, no,
I don't think it's right.
Yeah. But Chuck says, no, I want the newspaper, and they argue over it, don't they? And he knocks it on the floor because he says, no, it's my newspaper, give it back.
He takes it back, yeah.
So he takes it back.
But now we throw the paper seller guy's been hurt.
Yes.
In a fire or something. And he looks at his paper and it's there.
Yes.
In there. And it says, turn to page whatever.
Yeah.
And there's no page, that number's gone. And he realises that Chuck had taken that page.
Yeah, because he's upset that he'd missed it in the paper.
Yeah, he is.
Because
instead of doing bets, he could have been doing something good.
Yeah, and he sort of reflects. He's sitting in the park reflecting as they
do. There's a long reflection.
Oh, there's always reflections in the park, isn't it? It's not, no one ever goes there for anything else but reflections. There's sort of sad people everywhere, just leave me alone, I'm reflecting.
Yeah, that's why I have so many benches spread out.
Yeah, wait for the music.
Yeah.
You never get a mariachi band when people are reflecting. So he goes back to this hotel, doesn't
yeah.
he? And he finds the receptionist. She's there, isn't she?
She is, yeah. With her dog.
With her dog, yeah.
That's quick. That's fast.
Yeah, and he goes to have a shower.
Yeah.
And he opens up the shower curtain and she's standing there.
Yeah.
And, then he realises...
He turned around.
Yeah, but she's blind.
Yeah.
Or is she? That old trick.
The dog can see.
Ah, it's a seeing dog. But he's not... Gary says he's not happy. He's failed his friend. He's failed the newspaper guy, hasn't
he? She wants to know what's wrong, so he tells her all this. And she tells, maybe it's from God. You know, God works in mysterious ways. Maybe this is his way.
Yeah.
Reaching out.
Yeah.
It's a miracle.
And Gary reads about a bank holdup, doesn't he?
Yeah, 9 killed in a bank robbery.
Yeah.
Frank, the out-of-work guy who they turned down for a loan or something, goes back.
Yes, and she convinces him to go to the cops.
Yes.
And the cop is... Come on, there was a cue there.
I've got to switch it on.
Oh, man.
A woman.
You said it, sir.
I've got Tagliatelle. But I don't think that was her name. But it was close enough.
Desperate housewife.
She was a desperate housewife. Detective Tagliatelle.
Well, yeah.
Or whatever, yeah.
But she doesn't believe him. They never do. But she's a bit curious about it.
No, she's keeping an eye on him as he's leaving.
Yeah.
And she sees what friends
Because she
he's
calls
with.
Up her desk sarge and she says, there's anything unusual being called in today?
At the bank.
At the bank. And he went,
a UFO,
UFO or flying pig, something like that. Yeah, UFO. Okay.
I want to report a crime.
Well, lucky for you, you're in a police station. Sit down. When did it happen? Today?
No, not exactly.
Yesterday? Last week?
Well, it hasn't happened yet, but it's going to unless you stop it.
Domestic dispute?
No. No, it's a robbery. Well, at least it starts out that way at the First National Bank. You see, at least it's gonna be.
Uh-huh. Do you have any ID?
Yeah. The guy's name is Frank Price. He's out of work. He got turned down for a loan, and he's a very desperate man.
Okay, let me get this straight. We've got a guy, a bank, a loan, some kind of robbery.
Well, no. It's not a robbery yet, but it's gonna be.
Gonna be. Just for the record, not that I doubt you. You know this because...
I can't tell you
that. Oh, Grady. Have you heard of anything over at First National Bank?
Yeah, flying saucers.
So we're on to it.
Thank you.
And they all go to the diner, don't they?
Oh, this is where he gets hold of the paper.
Yeah, that's where they're all at the diner. And they're all arguing about it,
aren't
they?
runs off after finding, after fiddling with the paper I've got.
Yeah.
And this is where he gets the page.
Yeah, because the headline changes now, doesn't it?
It says 10 dead.
10 dead, yeah. And he realises that, is it Marcy, whatever
Marcy, yeah, I think.
She's going to go.
She's going to go down to the bank because he won't go.
Yeah. And he makes it to the bank just in time, doesn't he? He calls out to Marcy, what the hell are you doing, blah, blah,
just
blah.
Just as Frank walks.
Just as, yeah.
And he says, Frank!
Yeah.
He goes, and then he says, don't anybody move.
Yeah, because he pretends it's him, doesn't yeah, he? That yeah. He's the yeah, bank robber.
Because Frank hasn't got his gun out. He's reaching for it, but he doesn't.
Yeah.
Then him and Frank get trapped in the lift for a bit.
Yeah.
Then they're up on the roof.
Yep, yep, they're yeah. All the cops turn up suddenly. Yeah. Loads of cops. And the female cop turns up.
And Chuck turns up as yeah. well.
Yeah. But Frank pulls a gun on Gary anyway, doesn't yeah. he? And says, you know, what are you giving it? And Gary kind of explains how he knows Frank.
Yeah.
Because he says, how do you know my name? He goes, oh, I know you got turned down for a loan.
Yeah.
And, it's not gone your way. You got made redundant at the, like, a mill or wherever yeah. it was still.
He says, I know how you feel.
Yeah. And ooh. Frank says, you don't. But he starts to open up to Gary, doesn't he? He goes, yeah. oh, I've got wife and kid, 16 kids. God,
16. I would have robbed the bank too, I think.
And Gary gives him the money, doesn't he?
He says, yeah. He goes,
because I've got, where did the money come from?
That was Chuck. Chuck had been betting.
Yeah,
it,
that's right.
Because he took the page, he'd been betting at a bar.
He goes find Chuck, doesn't he? Yeah.
Earlier on.
Yeah. Yeah. And he takes this suitcase of money.
Because Chuck's been in the bar saying, oh, the next football is watching American football.
Yeah.
And he's watching, oh, the next will be a touchdown or the next will be a fumble.
He goes, how the hell? Yeah,
and they know betting.
Yes, right. And he gets like a briefcase of money.
Yeah, 3,200 or something he's got in there.
Yeah. And Gary gives Frank the money, doesn't he?
He offers it to him.
Yeah.
He says, but then Frank says to him, did money ever help your problems?
And he went, no.
No.
So they decide to throw it off the roof, don't
yeah.
they?
Yeah.
They just throw all the money off the roof.
And of course that breaks the police lines, people scrambling to yeah. get the money and stuff.
The police don't know who's the robber now or anything. Think. Yeah, so, because they didn't rob anything.
No, there wasn't a stick up the thing.
Yeah.
And
but the female cop arrests Gary, doesn't she?
She does, yeah, because obviously he went to see her, so.
16 years. I worked that job, never missed a day. And you think you're building something like a future or your family, and then one day, you know, just like that, it's gone.
Yeah.
I looked everywhere for work and there's nothing. That's why I came here. This is the place I kept my money in. Your savings and all those years. And you know what they said to me? They said they couldn't take the risk. Like I was asking for a handout. Or like I was nothing. Yeah, and so,
what am I supposed to do now?
Yeah, it's... My wife's gonna be really upset.
She loves you, huh?
It was 19 years, you know. You know, three kids.
It'd be a shame to lose that, Frank. Wife and kids. It'd be a shame to lose that.
Yeah, well. You think that,
they never even saw the gun, Frank. And if money'll help, it's yours.
Yeah, but did it help you?
No.
So she's taking him back, because... Oh, that's right, because the desk sergeant, well, it can't be a desk sergeant, but she said, you know, is there anything going unusual here? And he went, yeah, there's UFOs this time, isn't there?
Yeah.
So, yeah, they arrest him, but he doesn't want anything to ditch. He gets released, doesn't he?
Yeah, because he hasn't done anything.
Yeah. So he says he's going to leave the hotel. He's fed up with this. He doesn't want the newspaper. He never asked for this.
Right. No.
So he's now in a shack.
In the middle of the woods.
Yeah, you presume. Yeah.
And there it is, the meow.
Yeah, he hears the meow and the newspaper's turned up. Yeah. And next minute, Gary's back in the city.
Yeah.
Because he's like, I can't fight this. Whatever reasons,
yeah,
it's happening. And he's talking to, is it Marcy, isn't
Marcy,
it?
Marcy, yeah.
And he's like, I'll just have to accept this and see what I can do. And that's kind of it, isn't it?
Yeah, he says, I might give Frank some money or something. He says,
yeah,
about winning the lottery.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. He says, yeah, Frank might get some money soon.
So, yeah.
There are no explanations, of course, but that's nothing new. Magic's like life, mostly unexpected. Which means, newspaper or not, you can never be sure what's around the corner or what you'll do when you find it.
Hey, Marissa!
What took you so long?
I had a hunch about the lottery. I thought I might send some of the money to Frank.
Well, that's a good idea.
How's Sherman?
Oh, he's fine. Be back at the newsstand in 2 weeks. So, decided what to do with the rest of your life?
Gotta find a new place to live. A place that takes cats.
And then?
Gotta buy a kitty litter box.
And that's kind of the end of the episode, isn't it?
Yeah, that is, yeah.
Yeah.
There's an outro, a little voiceover outro, and that's it. I'll put that on.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's we're done.
We're done.
Well, that's not bad, is it?
No.
We could go through them quick when we've got things to do.
I used to watch this.
I used to watch it as well.
I can't say I've seen every episode because I looked up Wikipedia and I don't remember the ending, but I did. I certainly used to watch this.
Yeah.
I quite liked it.
Yeah, I did as well. I enjoyed it still.
Yeah, it was. There's this slight fun element, isn't it? Because obviously Chuck's always trying to get money.
It's a little tongue in cheek.
Yeah.
I think Gary and Marcy are the only ones who stay in it for the full four seasons.
I thought Chuck did.
No, yeah. No. I looked it up. He wasn't a stayer.
Ah, well. Yeah.
And I only see the detective in this one episode as well, so I thought it might be a recurring thing.
Apparently she does.
Oh, maybe she does.
Yeah, apparently, yeah, I looked it up. She does reoccur. The ending, apparently, it's something to do, he gets a penknife or something.
Yeah.
And the initials are on the penknife. And that tells him who's going... His initials appeared on this penknife, and it meant the person before him gave him the newspaper.
Right.
And then towards the end, he meets a young girl and he gets a pen and her initials appear or something. And so the idea being that she would then get the newspaper.
Oh, right.
It's supposed to be like a gift from God.
Yeah, well, apparently the co-creator of it, Ian Adams, says the newspapers are delivered by Mark Twain because he lost the bet with God or something.
Oh, right. Yeah, and he... The idea was premised was that he was going to hand the newspaper to her. She was then going to take it over.
Yeah. The fan club, Eels.
Yes.
Early edition lovers.
Yeah, I know there was a big hoo-ha when it was taken off.
Because they campaigned to try and get it back on the air.
Yeah. As I say, they did try and finish it.
That's how
it was supposed to be, that this young girl was going to get the newspaper. Whether they were then film what happened to her, who knows? But you do get to previously meet, I think, who had it before him.
Oh, right.
There is a couple of episodes, or he finds out who had it before him.
I know I've watched it. I used to watch it, but I don't really remember any.
No, I don't remember this ending sort of thing.
I mean, it would have been in the 90s. I would have seen it probably. It would have been early 2000s.
Yeah.
So
I think BBC picked it up the first season.
I think it was on Sky One, as I seem to remember watching it on there.
I certainly saw maybe the first season.
Yeah, probably one of the other channels did. Because it premiered on the 28th of September, 1996, and a year later on Sky in January.
Well, maybe, yeah.
Sky One, it says.
Yeah, maybe it was.
Yeah, I've got my big book of facts.
Oh, big book of facts.
Which has none. It just lists the first three seasons.
Oh, is it the Alexa big book of facts then?
No, I could ask
Alexa. No, you know.
But the trouble is, there's more programmes called that. There's like sports programmes, everything.
She's probably going to announce Bobby Brown, who was in New Edition. So, Are we going to rate this program?
We are. We usually do, don't we?
Well, we try to.
I'll just go have a look at the quick look at the cast. Cast. Yeah. Fisher Stevens was only in 48 episodes.
Oh.
So, yeah.
Was that the police woman then?
No, that was the guy.
Oh, was it? Okay.
Chuck. Oh, yes. No. I'm not getting this police woman. I suppose that's 9 episodes. I'm going down the episodes rating.
That's a bit like us, isn't it, really?
Yeah. Well, if this police woman was in it again, she wasn't in many episodes.
No, I thought it said that she was. Maybe it was me.
Yeah, I think it's got to be
you. It's usually me.
It's always you.
No, I don't know. It's always me. I don't know why you bother listening to me. No one else does.
Unless you changed her name halfway through. Or they hired someone else to do it.
Anyway, she went on to do Desperate Housewives.
She certainly did.
If anything else, I don't remember.
I was going to have a quick look. Fisher Stevens, I know I've seen him in loads of programmes. I just wondered if any of them stand out. He was the bad guy in Hackers. Wait a minute, I do remember that.
Ah.
Do you remember the film Hackers? Angelina Jolie.
Possibly. Possibly, I can't say I do.
The true world of hacking revealed. It really was. Yeah. He must have done Murder, She Wrote, come on. Everybody's done Murder, She Wrote.
Don't be like that, that's a bit harsh, isn't it?
Yeah, he was in the early edition.
You may have thought you've seen him in other programmes, such as...
There you go, Hackers. He was in one episode of Friends.
Well, that means nothing to me.
Yes, until we do it on the podcast, you won't know anything about Friends.
Don't
know. He's got more. Oh, he was in Short Circuit 2.
Yeah.
He played the Asian guy.
The Asian guy?
Yeah.
Okay.
And that means he was in Short Circuit 1 as well. He played an Indian guy.
Vaguely, now you're saying
it. He black-faced up. It wouldn't be done nowadays, I'm sure. That's probably where I remember him from as well. So, shall we rate?
We shall indeed.
Out of a score of 10?
Well, I like this. I quite like this. I still liked it. I wouldn't watch another episode, but I still liked it.
You wouldn't buy the box set and binge watch it?
No.
If it was on telly?
No.
All right, okay. You've been there, done that.
Yeah. But I would say...
As a pilot episode?
Yeah, I'll give it a 7.5.
Oh God, you're so awkward. Round it up. 7.5, okay. I'm going to give it a solid 8, because I think it was very well done.
It is very well done.
It was enjoyable.
Yeah.
How many times can we say that when we watch programmes?
That very rare. Especially of the last 126 episodes.
And I'm sure next week's will be more enjoyable though.
Well, quite possibly. If it's... Well, could it be more enjoyable?
We're going to the island.
We are.
The fantasy one.
How are we going to get there?
The plane!
On the plane! The plane!
So next week we're doing Fantasy Island.
Indeed.
Mr. Rourke.
Mr. Rourke, indeed.
Was he Tattoo?
Yes, Tattoo.
The Bond villain?
Yeah, don't mention that.
Was it the man with the golden gun?
He is the man with the golden gun.
But he's not the man with the golden
gun. Well, he could have been.
We all know who the man with the golden gun is.
Scaramanga.
Yeah, Scaramanga. Yeah. Played by?
Christopher Lee.
Yeah. So, and he was his little henchman?
Oh, don't call
him. Or butler?
Yeah. Dwarf.
I'm only mentioning it that his part was small, not that he was.
Oh, I don't know about that bit.
Though he lives, he survives.
He does survive.
We think.
Well, yeah, he survived.
Don't they put him up in a basket?
They put him in a basket.
On a boat.
On the top of the mast.
Without food or water.
Well.
That we know of.
He's French.
Maybe they just wheel him down at night.
He was French.
He was French.
Just leave it there. He was French. He deserved that.
He probably did. You're right.
alienate the people of the world.
And we'll be watching France lose tonight, won't we?
No, probably not. Actually, yes, no, I think Belgium could do it. I think Belgium might win the World Cup. But there's, who knows?
When this goes out, we'll know, and I can just edit it.
Yeah, just edit it, don't worry about it.
I can't believe we won. This is the most unlikely thing I'll be saying. And that's a nice short episode.
Indeed it was.
So then we can go and watch the football.
Then we can go and watch it. Yeah. Whoever may be playing, it's not winning.
Belgium. Nobody in the world.